Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to install Portainer on a Raspberry Pi. Portainer is a lightweight and open source container management tool. It allows you to easily create, manage, and delete your Docker containers through a web interface. Before we begin this guide, there's two things you will want to do. First, you'll want to set a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi. The best way to achieve this is through DHCP reservation, but you can still achieve this through the operating system itself. We will link to a guide on this below. Secondly, you will need Docker already installed on your Raspberry Pi. If you haven't done this already, we'll link to our Docker installation guide in the description below. While this guide focuses on using Raspberry Pi OS, you should be able to get away with using any other Debian-based operating system such as Ubuntu. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi. You can do this either directly or by using SSH. First up, let's ensure that our Raspberry Pi OS is up to date by typing in sudo apt update to update the package list. Once the list has been updated, you can upgrade any out of date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. Now before we begin installing Portainer to your Raspberry Pi, let's verify that you have Docker installed by typing in docker space hyphen hyphen version. If Docker is available, you should see its version number printed to the terminal. At this point, we can now proceed with setting up Portainer on our Raspberry Pi. To begin this process, we'll pull the Portainer image by typing in docker space pull space Portainer slash Portainer hyphen CE followed by colon symbol then latest. The latest tag at the end ensures this command will pull the latest available version of Portainer. With the image now downloaded, our next step is to create a Docker volume. We will use this named volume to store Portainer's data. Creating this new volume is as easy as typing in docker space volume space create space Portainer underline data. We are using a named volume instead of a bind mount because Portainer is able to manage it better. We are finally at the point where we can start up Portainer. To do this, type in docker space run space hyphen d space hyphen p space 8000 colon symbol 8000 space hyphen p space 9443 colon 9443 space hyphen hyphen name equals Portainer space hyphen hyphen restart equals always space hyphen v space slash var slash run slash docker.sock colon symbol slash var slash run slash docker.sock. Now after this, type in space hyphen v space Portainer underline data colon slash data followed by space and then Portainer slash Portainer hyphen ce colon symbol latest. With this command, we are telling Docker to run the Portainer image in the background. We are opening up port 8000, which is used for the SSH tunnel built into Portainer, and also opening port 9443, which is used for Portainer's web interface. In addition to this, we mount two volumes. The first is mounting the Docker socket so that Portainer can interact with Docker. The second volume mounts our Portainer underlined data volume we created earlier. We also assign this container the name Portainer and set the restart value to always to ensure that Docker will automatically restart Portainer if it crashes. After running this command, you should now have Portainer up and running on your Raspberry Pi. You can verify the container is running by typing in docker space ps. If everything has worked properly, you should see Portainer listed by this command. There's still a couple of things we will need to do before Portainer is fully up and running on your Raspberry Pi. To finish this off, we will need to access Portainer's web interface. If you don't know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, you can easily get it by using hostname space hyphen capital I in the terminal. In our example, you can see that our IP address was 192.168.0.32. Now, in your favorite web browser, go to https://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, which in our case is 192.168.0.32. end this URL by typing in the colon symbol and then follow up with the port 9443. As Portainer generates a self-signed certificate, you'll get a warning that your connection is not private. You get this error as the web browser is not able to verify a self-signed certificate. To ignore this warning, click Advanced and then click the Proceed link. First time you start up Portainer, you will be required to create your admin account. To do this, you will probably want to type in a new username by replacing admin with that username. Next, type in a secure password that you use to access your Portainer installation. It's incredibly important to set a secure password as this user will have full control over Docker running on your Raspberry Pi. Additionally, this password must be at least 12 characters long. Once you have typed it in, click the Create User button to proceed. You have now successfully installed and configured Portainer on your Raspberry Pi. For these next few steps, we will be walking you through how you can use the Portainer web interface to set up a Docker container on your Raspberry Pi. You'll see that this interface makes the whole process relatively easy as you don't have to mess around with the command line interface. Start off this whole process by changing to the Home dashboard by clicking Home in the sidebar. In this dashboard, you should see your local Docker environment. Click this to continue. Portainer will now have connected to your local Docker installation running on your Raspberry Pi. Our first step is to create a volume for the container that we are setting up. To do this, click Volumes in the sidebar. We already have a few volumes set up for some of the existing containers we are already running. To create a new volume, click the Add Volume button in the top right corner. All we need to do now is give a name for this new Docker volume. For this example, we'll be calling ours VW-data. After typing in a name for the volume, scroll down and click the Create the Volume button. You should now see your new volume listed on this page. It should also say unused next to it. The next step would be to set up the container itself. We can do this by changing to the container screen using the sidebar. Once on this screen, click the Add Container button in the top right corner. For this particular example, we will be setting up Vault Warden on our Raspberry Pi using Portainer. To start defining a new container, first off, type in a name for it, which in our case will be Vault Warden. You will next need to type in the name of the image you want downloaded for this container. In our case, you'll be using vaultwarden/server:latest. Please note that out of the box, Portainer only has the official Docker container repository configured. Next, if the container you're using uses networking at all, you'll want to expose some ports. To do this, scroll down and click the Map Additional Port button. On the left side, you'll set the port for how it will appear on the host system. On the right side, you'll type in the port that's been exposed from the container itself. You also need to specify whether this is using the TCP or UDP protocols. In this example, we are exposing port 80 from the container using the port 8080 on our host system. Now scroll down until you see the Advanced Container Settings header. Here, you can control various things such as the networking, environment variables, and volumes. For this example, we will be adjusting the restart policy and the volumes. With the restart policy option, we can get Docker to automatically restart this container if it ever crashes. We do this by clicking Always. Next up, as Vault Warden has persistent data it needs stored, we will need to switch to the Volumes tab. To map a volume to this container, click the Map Additional Volume button. Using the top text box, we can specify where this volume will be mounted to within the container itself. For this example, we want to mount our /data/directory within the container to the VW data volume we created earlier. With that configured, all we need to do now is click the Deploy the Container button to start up this software on our Raspberry Pi. Your list of containers will now update with the container that you just created. Like with our example, you can see that Vault Warden is now listed as one of our containers. You can get more information about your container by clicking it. At this point, you should have successfully gotten Portainer up and running on your Raspberry Pi. If you liked this tutorial, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.